Hello everyone. In this tutorial, we will focus on internal structure of Keras LSTM layer in order to understand how many learnable parameters an LSTM layer has. Why do we need to care of calculating number of parameters in LSTM layer since we can easily get this number in the model summary report? Well, there are several reasons. First of all, to calculate the number of learnable parameters correctly, we need to understand how LSTM is structured and how LSTM operates in depth. Thus, we will delve into LSTM gates and gate functions. We will gain precious insight about how LSTM handles time-dependent or sequence input data. Secondly, in artificial neural network models, number of parameters is a really important metric for understanding the whole model capacity and complexity. We need to keep an eye on the number of parameters of each layer in the model to handle overfitting or underfitting situations. One way to prevent these situations is to adjust the number of parameters of each layer. We need to know how number of parameters actually affects the performance of each layer. If you want to enhance your understanding of LSTM layer and learn how many learnable parameters it has, please continue this tutorial. By the way, I would like to mention that in my YouTube channel, I have a dedicated playlist in English all about LSTM and in Turkish. You can check this playlist to learn more about LSTM. Lastly, if you want to be notified for upcoming tutorials about LSTM and deep learning, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and activate notifications. Thank you. Now, let's get started. Here you see the references that I am using, and some images are coming from these references. I would like to remind important information about LSTM. LSTM expects input data to be a three-dimensional tensor. The first dimension is batch size. How many samples in batch during training and testing. The second dimension is the time steps, means that how many values exist in a sequence. For example, 4, 7, 8, 4 sequence, there are 4 time steps. And the last dimension is the feature. It shows how many dimensions are used to represent a data in one time samples. First example, if each value in the sequence is one hot encoded with 90 and 11, then the feature is 10. Let me show you some example. Assume that that's the sequence, 4 time steps in raw format. So each item in the sequence is an integer, but we use one hot encoding format with 10 dimensions. So the feature is now 10. So that each integer is represented by 9 zeros and only one value. Here, single one. Okay, let me show you a sample LSTM model. By the way, you can access this Colab notebook from the link in the video descriptions. Here we already defined the time step as 40. So how many steps in the input? Here is the feature is defined as 3. So the dimensionality of each input representation in the sequence. And here is the LSTM output dimension with 2. So the dimensionality of the LSTM output, hidden or cell states, they are represented by vectors. This is the dimension of that vector. Okay. Here we use the input by using the time steps and features. And we have already defined the LSTM layer with the LSTM output dimension with 2. And we provided the input, so input have 40 time steps and each is represented by 3 dimensions. Here is our model constructed and here is the summary. So if we go over the summary, we would see that the output is 2 scalar values. So this is the reason why we set this. So that's the output dimension here. And you see that number of parameters is 48. And now in this tutorial, we are gonna go over and understand how this number come out. Okay, but before explaining how to calculate the number of parameters in LSTM, we would like to remind you how to calculate the number of dense layers. Okay, it would be easier. As we will see soon, LSTM has four dense layers in its structure, so this discussion will help us a lot soon. Assume that the input size is represented by I, the size of the hidden layer, the number of neurons in the hidden layer is H, and the output size, the number of neurons in the output layer is O. For a single hidden layer, we can calculate the number of parameters in the model. Connections between layers, we have only two actually layers, and biases in every layer, we have only two layers, hidden and output layers. Then we can count the numbers by multiplying the each layer connections and adding the biases. Let me show you these here. So we have the input for three dimension input, okay? A vector with three dimensions. And hidden layers, you see that we have five units. And output, you see that we have two neurons. So for the weights, we need to calculate the number of connections here. So how can we calculate it since it's dense layer? By multiplying this three by five. And this is the number of weights here. And five by two, here are the number of the parameters or weights here. And including the biases, so each neuron here have the biases and each neuron have the biases. So this formula is simply correct. So let's do the calculation together if you like. Now the connections between the input and the hidden layer is I times H, and this is 3 times 5. So there are 15 connections. So each connection must have one weight. So 15 weights between the input and hidden layer. Now let's calculate hidden and output layer between. So we see that there are 10 connections. So it means that there are 10 weights. So we already calculated the connections weights. Now we can calculate the bias every layer. We know that each neuron has one bias here and here. So total we have 5 plus 2 biases. So let's do the calculation. We will end up 32. Let me show with an example here. Now I have only the input as 3 scalar values. And here is the dense layer with 5 neurons. And here is the output layer 2 neurons. And in the summary, you would see that in the end, we have total 32 parameters. That's what we calculated. Thus, we can formalize this calculation. So, I is the input, H is the hidden, and O is the output layer. So, here is the number of the connections between the input and hidden layer. Here is the number of the connections between hidden and output layer. Here is the total bias numbers in the hidden and output layer. So, you can rearrange these, and you will end up this formulation. So we will use this formula below soon. Please review the figure to capture the internal structure of LSTM cell. There are three inputs to the LSTM cell. Previous hidden state value, previous cell state value, current time steps input value. There are four dense layers: forget gate, input gate, candidate gate, and output gate. The input-output tensor sizes dimensions are symbolized with circles. In the figure, cell and hidden states are vectors which have dimension 2. This number is defined by the programmer by setting LSTM parameter units, LSTM output dimension 2. Input is a vector which has a dimension 3. This number is also defined by the programmer by deciding how many dimensions would be represent an input. For example, dimension of one-hot encoding, word embedding, etc. Please note that, by definition, hidden and cell states vectors dimensions must be the same. Hidden and cell state vector dimensions at time t1 and at time t must be the same. Each input in the sequence must have the same vector dimensions. Let's focus on forget gate. As seen in above figure, there are hidden state values, two previous hidden states, red circles here, and three three green circles which represents the input at that time. Total five numbers, that is two from the previous hidden state, three from the current input. So actually these inputs are fed into the a dense layer, and the dense layer output has two neurons. Why? Because this number of the neurons must be equal to the dimension of the hidden states, because they will create the next hidden states. We can calculate the number of parameters in this dense layer as we did before, so we can calculate. So basically it is the total number of inputs, which are the previous hidden state plus the current input state dimension, times the number of hidden state, the number of the hidden states here, so there are two actually neurons, plus the biases for each neuron, and the number of the neurons is equal to the dimension of the hidden state. So we use the hidden state dimension as the number of the output neurons. So basically when we put the numbers inside, we end up 12. So the forget gate has 12 parameters, including weights and biases for here. If you check again the internal structure, you remember that we have four dense networks, and exactly with the same structure. Therefore, we are going to end up with 4 by 12, 48 parameters total. We can formulate the parameter numbers in LSTM layer. Given that X is the input dimension, H is the number of LSTM unit cells, latent space, output dimension, there are many names. So we can calculate 4 by, because there are 4 dense layers or dense networks. X plus H, these are the inputs for each dense layer. And times H, this is the number of output. And plus H, these are the biases for each of them. And that's ends up with R calculation. So we now understand how to calculate the number of LSTM parameters. We can use this formula. I will not stop here. I would like to continue with a second explanation using LSTM function definitions. So this is the graphical representation of the LSTM layer, but we can use a mathematical representation of the LSTM layer as well. Here you see that forget gate here. So we have a sigma function. So actually it's a sigmoid function, okay, mostly. And with a weight matrices, multiplies the input, a U matrix, a weight matrix, multiplies the hidden, previous hidden state vector. And here is a bias vector. So when you do this calculation and then apply the sigmoid activation function, you will end up with the output of the forget gate here. So actually there are four networks, neural dense layers or dense neural networks. So we end up with four formulas, functions for each network. Let me focus on first the forget gate function. Okay, in the forget gate function, if you focus on there, notice that we can get this shape of W, U and B. Given that input size, the hidden previous hidden size, and the input size at the time t, and output size, and we know that output size must be equal to the input hidden previous hidden size. So we know that to multiply a matrix with a vector, there must be there the second dimension of the matrix and the first dimension of the vector must be in accordance with it, so they must be equal to each other. So we can calculate these, and we know that at the end of that function, the output must be the size of a previous hidden state. It must be. So For the W parameter, it must be the h by x size. Why? Because it will multiply by the xt, the current input, and the current input is a vector by the size of x by 1. So to multiply the W, and in the end we would like to end up with h vector, size of the h vector. So it must be h by x. And what about the u vector? Actually, for the same applies u vector, because u vector will multiply the h. So it must be ending with the h, and the result must be h by 1, and h is by 1 here. So we multiply the u, h by h matrix multiplies h by 1, the ending with h 1 by 1. And the biases, of course, we know from here. And because of the resulting function must be h by 1, so it must be the h parameters in that. So total parameters, we can collect the w parameters, u parameters, and biases. Here h by x is the size of w, h by h is the size of u, and h is the size of biases. So in the end we can come up with that x plus h times h plus h, that's exactly what we already calculated above. So we end up with the same, exactly the same parameter formulation here. Now let me go over an example quickly. Here I define the time steps 40, so it means that there are 40 integers, for example. So the feature is 3, so it means that we are going to represent each input by 3-dimensional vector. So the LSTM output dimension is 2. It means that we are gonna symbolize or the dimension of the vector of hidden states and the cell states 2. Here we have the input 40 by 3. And here are the LSTM, and we request LSTM output dimension should be only 2. Now we created the model. Now we have the model summary. Again we have the 48. And I will go over these a little bit more, because if you put the numbers in R formula, remember that R formula 4 by for each dense network, x plus h, the total input size, times h, that's the output neuron number, plus h, this is the biases for each neuron. And we already know that the 48 we can calculate, but let me show you from the model itself. So I can get the weights of the LSTM layer with the 0, 1, and 2 indices. So actually the first indices give me the W weight, then U weight, and the biases. So I will print all these onto the screen, so please focus on here. Now W is 24, U is 16, and B is 8. Why this? Because we can calculate the total number of W's which can be implemented at each time steps. So this is 4 by features. So remember that we select the feature 3, and LSTM output dimension, remember it is 2. So 4 by 3 by 2 is 24. For the U, remember that we calculated the 4 by LSTM output dimension by LSTM output dimension. So it's gonna be 4 by 2 by 2, 16. So if you like, I can remind you what I am talking about here. So remember that we say that for the W, it must be H times X. And we say that for the U, it must be H times H. And the bias, it must be h. So these numbers are coming from that calculation here. So it must be 4xh, 4hh, and 4h. So that's the each of them. And when you put all of them, you will end up with the 48. So notice that the above W, U, and B are compacted for all gates. These are not for each input size, but it is compacted, all right? But if you want to, you can access all each gate values. I mean the forget gate, input gate, candidate gate, and output gate as it is here. You can run this collab notebook and print out the results by yourself. Now, I have a question here. Time step or input length of the input sequence does not affect the number of parameters. Why? That's a really, really important question. So the time steps does not have effect on the number of parameters. Even it is 4 time steps, if it is 40 time steps, it's 400. It does not important. Why? Because W, U, and B matrices and vectors are shared throughout the time steps of the LSTM layer. That is, instead of using new weights and biases at each time step, LSTM uses the same W and B values for all the time steps, which simplifies the calculation of backpropagation and reduces the number of parameters, so the memory requirement. So that's very important for us. One can implement other ways, but that's the implementation of LSTM, so that W, U, and B are shared throughout the time steps. That's why the number of time steps does not have an effect on the number of parameters. Let me conclude. In this tutorial, we investigate the internal structure of Keras LSTM layer to calculate the number of learnable parameters. We examine several concepts, time steps, dimensionality of the output space, gates, gate functions, etc. We come up with the correct formulation in two different ways. So LSTM parameter number is 4 times x plus h times h plus h. We check the correctness of the formulation by creating a simple LSTM model. And we also note that the time steps does not have any effect on the number of parameters. From here, you can continue learning about LSTM, for example, with understanding the output of LSTM layer. I have a tutorial for it already on YouTube and Medium. So thank you for watching.